I was trying to remember when I saw you coming down the red carpet. We've done this type of interview already before, and I think it was for this project that you're nominated.
The Drawer Boy.
Yes. Congratulations, man. I mean, when you're putting stuff together and you know you're being part of something, you never really think about awards or anything. But when nominations come in, that's got to be bonus for all the hard work that you do.
Well, it is. It's a real treat. But I'll tell you what's the nicest thing is one of my co-players, Richard Clarkin's also up in the same category. So we're up against one another, and we had a third fella, Jacob Eamon. It was sort of the three of us were shared the leads of it, and. He's here tonight sharing the fun, at least. So.
That is fantastic. Look, for folks who don't know about it, what's it about?
It's about two bachelor farmers in the 70s who live on a farm. They've known one another for years. And suddenly a young actor arrives on their doorstep and asks to be a part of the farm experience for a while as he's trying to figure out a story about farming. And through the course of it, through the power of art, he starts to find out some hidden secrets in their lives. And the two of them had gone off to war together, and as a result, the war had changed their lives, you know, forever. And so the young boy helps them to come to grips with that.
Where did the story come from?
Well, the story came originally from Michael Healy, who wrote the play. It was a stage play, and the play, I think it was one of the most produced plays internationally, one of the most Canadian plays, you know, to be produced around the world. And then, and in the States, I think it's about number 10 to ever be produced. So it's a fantastic play. And, yeah. So.
But you know how some plays work as a play. How were you still able to take the essence of a story like that to make it, you know, for the screen?
Well, the nod for that really goes to the director and the producers. And what they did, you know, there was some, of course, some trimming that has to be done so that it's done cinematically. But what I think is special about this particular project is they let scenes play and they let time take its course in a scene and just allowed that breath to come in. So, although there was trimming of the actual stage play, what I think is a great marriage of cinema and theater in the project.
What other projects do you have coming up for 2018?
Well, right now I'm in the midst with my wife getting ready to open a play at Soul Pepper. So we're just in the midst of that, rehearsing Idomeneus, a Greek play, a contemporary take on a Greek play. Yeah, Greek myth. So I'm in the midst of that. We just came from rehearsal. So.
Wait, look, before you go, though, too, a lot of people these days, it's hard for them to follow their dreams. It's not an easy thing. You've been able to do it. What advice can you give somebody who is looking to follow their dream and hopefully be as successful as you are?
Keep at it. Keep at it. And have a hobby that you feel as passionate about as the work. And that will inform the work, and the work will inform the hobby, and you will have something that you feel passionate about during those times when maybe work's slow. I think that's what I would say.
Thank you so much. Have fun tonight, and again, congratulations.
Thank you so much.